Hello and welcome back to Adonia Academy. This is Maria here and it's lovely to see you guys back again. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon so that you get notified. Welcome to part 2 of the Indian bride dress wedding cake. If you've missed part 1, where I start off with the carving and stacking and ganaching, click on the link in the description box below or you can press the I above. So let's begin the decoration. After the cake is completely chilled, I'm using fondant. I've mixed blue and white ready-made Bizyon fondant and I've made it light blue. I'm also using ivory colored fondant first to drape over the neck and upper part of the torso. Roll it a little thick so that you hide the Rice Krispie Treat bumps and drape it on it and cut it with an X-Acto knife like so. After that, I'm rolling long pieces of light blue fondant. I've measured the top torso part. This is for the blouse. Cut out the neck with an X-Acto knife and drape it over the torso like so. Make sure you gather all the seams on the back side and there are no creases in the front. Again, with a sharp knife, cut near the waist like so and also trim off the back. Using a ball of similar color fondant, smoothen the fondant on the torso. Now you can decorate it as you wish. I'm using these teardrop shaped cutters to make impressions on it. You can decorate it however you wish. You can paint on it or put some motifs. I'm also using a Dresden tool to mark indents to make it like a leaf, and then I'm be using some gold edible luster dust mixed with gold paint and paint it carefully like so. When you're mixing gold luster dust with either alcohol or any medium, make sure it's paint like and not very watery. This will give you an even coat. Now remember, in the first part we had covered the board with cling wrap, so carefully remove that using a sharp knife. I'm rolling out long pieces for the skirt and using the onlay mat in a little different way. I'm just using that to make impressions of the design on the pieces and then we'll be draping it on the cake to start making the skirt. Measure the cake with a inch tape and carefully drape the long pieces. I'm starting from the back, if you notice. You can brush the cake with a little bit of water using a pastry brush and start draping like so. For the next line, for the next panel, I'm curling the edges a bit so that they look like pleats, and I'm going to continue draping the fondant all over the cake till I reach the front part. For the front, I'll be curling both the edges like so, both the sides, and then brushing it with a little water and then sticking it onto the cake. Make sure it's centered and in front. Doesn't have to be very neat. It's a skirt, so it can move a little here and there. Make sure the cake is covered. Once all the paneling is done, I'm rolling out a long piece of similar colored fondant and cutting it into a 2-inch wide strip, brushing it with some dry edible luster dust and using this to make the border of the skirt like so. I'm again using some gold paint with gold edible luster dust. I've mixed gold edible luster dust with some airbrush color, gold sheen airbrush color. And you can also use vodka or rejuvenator. I'm using that to paint all over the motifs. Use a thin brush and lots of patience and paint away. I've made some edible fabric using wafer paper. I leave a link in the description box for the video which I followed to make it. Painted a little bit on that using gold luster dust and draped it over the body like so to make the dupatta. I've also finished it off with some edible sugar lace painted in gold. My battery ran out, so I wasn't able to shoot this last part. Really sorry for that. So here it is already, my beautiful Indian bride dress wedding cake. I really hoped you liked it. If you did, please give this a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. It's free. Until next time, take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.